That concludes the debate on education failures and guaranteeing the 2022 exam diet. It's now time to move on to the next item of business, which is consideration of motion 2862 in the name of Claire Baker on the appointment of a member of the Standards Commission for Scotland. And I call on Claire Baker to move the motion on behalf of the Scottish Parliamentary Corporate Body.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I, along with Christine Graham and Maggie Chapman, was a member of the Corporate Body Appointment Panel, and I'm inviting MSPs this afternoon to agree the appointment of Suzanne Vestry as a member of the Standards Commission for Scotland. As the Chamber will know, the Corporate Body supports 7 independent office holders, and one of our statutory duties relates to appointing, with the agreement of the Parliament, some of the office holders. This appointment relates to the Standards Commission for Scotland. The Standards Commission is part of the Ethical Standards Framework, and its role is to encourage high ethical standards in public life by promoting and enforcing the codes of conduct for councillors and members of devolved public bodies. So the Commission has a convener and 4 members, all of whom are part-time. So let me turn to our nominee. Suzanne Vestry is a self-employed consultant providing a range of services to voluntary and public sector organisations, including organisational development advice, as well as designing and delivering a range of training. She is also a board member at the Scottish Children's Reporter Administration. We believe that Suzanne will bring the post professionalism, fairness and a strong commitment to ensuring high standards of conduct in public life are upheld. And I am sure the Parliament will want to wish her every success in her new role. Presiding Officer, I move the motion.
Thank you. The question on this motion will be put at decision time. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 2851 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau setting out a business programme. And I call on George Adam to move the motion.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and moved.
Thank you. No member has asked to speak on the motion, and the question is that motion 2851 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of Parliamentary Bureau motions 2852 and 2853 on approval of SSIs, and I ask George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau to move the motions.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and moved.
Thank you, and I call on Miles Briggs.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. Self-catering is an integral and hugely important part of the Scottish tourism sector in terms of jobs, revenues and the world-class experience that Scotland offers to visiting guests. The sector also generates some £867 million annually to the Scottish economy. Now, throughout the passage of the short-term lets regulations, significant concerns have been raised by the sector and those whose livelihoods depend on the income which they receive. Now, given the impact that the pandemic has had, we should be mindful of the unintended consequences and the potential negative impact which these new regulations will have on already fragile tourism businesses. SNP ministers clearly understood that when the licensing regulations were unfit and they removed them in February 2021. They largely remain unchanged, and having been tabled in January 2022, the industry and experts and members have been dismissed. Their concerns have been dismissed by ministers. Now, there are real concerns, and I share these. Yes.
Willie Rennie.
I thank the member for giving way. Liberal Democrats support the introduction of control areas, but for problematic short-term let hotspots. But we think the licensing scheme, like him, is disproportionate, and we think a registration scheme would be a far more sensible way to proceed. But does the member recognise that the concern doesn't just come from these benches and those benches, but also from the wise Mr Fergus Ewing, who has expressed concern recently in committee? Does he think that the minister should pay attention to that concern and actually make changes?
Miles Briggs.
Thank the member for that intervention. I absolutely do. And as the member has outlined, these concerns are shared across the sector, including the Association of Scotland Self-Caterers, the Professional Association of Self-Caterers UK, Scottish Agritourism, Scotland's Best B&Bs and the Scottish Bed and Breakfast Association, as well as Scotland Land and Estates. What is concerning is that the views of this sector, as Willie Rennie has outlined, has not been taken on board, and that a workable solution which has been put forward in the form of the registration scheme has been put to one side by SNP ministers. Indeed, the whole short-term let sector is united in favouring a registration scheme. The sector has support also from the Federation of Small Business, NFU Scotland, as well as all short-term let organisations. And it's worth reflecting that several of these bodies actually were so angry against the Scottish Government that they felt the need to leave the short-term lets stakeholder working group because they felt it was a sham, in their words, and that it was not addressing their concerns in any constructive way. Presiding Officer, as has already been mentioned by Willie Rennie, I also welcome the comments from my SNP colleague Fergus Ewing, who's discovered his independence on the back benches, when he said at committee, and I fully agree with this, the licensing scheme is too draconian and unfair. There will now be a period of division, difficulty and anxiety amongst tens of thousands of...
If you could please conclude, Mr Briggs.
I will. There will now be anxiety amongst tens of thousands of law-abiding small businesses that have done nothing to deserve the threat that is now held over them. I ask that Parliament reject the licensing order at decision time. Thank you very much.
Thank you. And I call on Shona Robison.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. This legislation delivers on our commitment to effectively regulate short-term lets. We recognise the important role short-term lets play as a source of flexible and responsive accommodation for tourists and workers, which bring many benefits to hosts, visitors and our economy. However, when this work started in 2018, it was in response to the significant concerns of residents and communities across Scotland, particularly in Miles Briggs area, I should add, about the impact that the increase in short-term lets were having on their areas, including on local housing supply, noise and antisocial behaviours. And this wasn't just an urban or rural issue, and this was shown in correspondence and then throughout our consultations, where we've heard from residents across the country, from Ayr to Applecross, the Trossachs to North Berwick and Skye to St Andrews. Constituents were regularly asking MSPs what action the government was taking to address that. And whilst we were taking time to gather the evidence and hear the views of people and stakeholders to agree what form such action would take. So I'm pleased that we have responded to those concerns with the clear action that we're voting on tonight, of course.
Miles Briggs.
I'm grateful for the Cabinet Secretary for taking this intervention. I've been working on this at committee with other members, and one of the clear asks, and none of us are against the change here, was that actually the Scottish Government, given the impact of the pandemic, looked towards a registration scheme, not a licensing scheme. Now, can she outline to Parliament why that was so categorically rejected and why people have had to leave the Government's own working group?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, if Miles Briggs and the Tories are not against the change, presumably they'll be voting for this at decision time. In terms of the licensing against registration, we've discussed this on many occasions. We considered registration as part of the 2019 consultation, and we've also considered the proposals from the Association of Scotland Self-Caterers made earlier last year. We don't believe that registration offers the same protections as licensing does to guests, neighbours and local communities. And to be robust and effective, essentially, a registration scheme would have to do many of the things that a licensing scheme would do. And the fit and proper person issue is critical, which is going to be in the licensing scheme, which would not be in the registration scheme. The working group, we're hoping, and many of the stakeholders have said they will continue to work with the government on the detail, and I'm pleased that many of them have said that. We have already introduced legislation allowing councils to establish short-term let control areas and manage numbers of short-term lets. The introduction of a licensing scheme will protect the safety of guests by ensuring all short-term lets across Scotland comply with a set of mandatory safety standards and ensure the people providing them are suitable. This will ensure short-term lets are safe while continuing to make a positive impact to local economies while balancing the needs of local communities. The licensing order, which was passed by the Local Government Housing Planning Committee last month, gives local authorities autonomy to tailor the scheme to address particular local issues and needs. It will enable them to know what is happening in
Please
their area,
conclude, be, Cabinet responsive, Secretary.
Be responsive and handle complaints effectively. We have engaged with stakeholders, we have listened, we have made changes, and we are also committed to work with local authorities to review
Thank
the
you,
levels
Cabinet
of
Secretary.
Short-term lets in hotspot areas in the summer of 2023. I urge members to support the motion.
Thank you. The question on these motions will be put at decision time. And the next item of business is consideration of Parliamentary Bureau Motion 2854 on designation of lead committee. And I ask George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau to move the motion.
Moved, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Minister. The question on this motion will be put at decision time, and there are 10 questions to be put as a result of today's business. And can I remind members that if the amendment in the name of Tom Arthur is agreed to, the amendment in the name of Mark Griffin will fall. And the first question is that amendment 2838.2 in the name of Tom Arthur, which seeks to amend motion 2838 in the name of Miles Briggs on protecting local government funding in Scotland, be agreed. Are we all agreed? The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote and there'll be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.